सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नाबार्ड। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर न्यू हियर, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन सो दैट यू कैन रिसीव ऑल द नोटिफिकेशंस रिगार्डिंग ऑल द लेटेस्ट वीडियोस and also you can join this telegram group for daily quizzes. All right, so let's begin with the very first question, which is about the Henley's passport index. And guys, remember one thing, that there are various passport index, but the most important passport index is this one, Henley's passport index. So the question can only be come from this index only. So you have to consider these statements regarding Henley's passport index and you have to identify the correct statement. All right, so let's discuss this index. So it has been released by Henley and Partners. Okay, Henley and Partners is a company which releases this Henley's passport index every year, and the data is collected by International Air Transport Association, which is headquartered in Montreal. And Montreal, guys, of course, is in Canada. And total 110 countries, total 110 countries were ranked in this year's Henley's passport index, and the very first edition of Henley's passport index was launched in the year 2006. All right, and now talking about the ranking, so once again Japan is at number one, and there are 191 countries in this world which are providing visa free access to the Japanese citizen. Japanese citizens ko visa free access 191 desh aise hain jo hamare puri duniya mein provide kara rahe hain. And सिंस 2018 से लेके अभी तक जापान का जो पासपोर्ट है वो सबसे ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है पूरे दुनिया में. जापान हैज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट पासपोर्ट इन द वर्ल्ड सिंस 2018, विच मीन्स जापान होल्ड्स रैंक नंबर वन इन द हेनलेस पासपोर्ट इंडेक्स सिंस 2018, विच मीन्स दिस इज द फोर्थ कंसेक्यूटिव ईयर्स व्हेन जापान इज एट द नंबर वन. टॉकिंग अबाउट अवर इंडिया, सो वी आर एट द रैंक 85, वी हैव स्लिप्ड बाय वन रैंक. लास्ट ईयर इट वॉज 84, एंड देर आर 58 नेशंस इन दिस वर्ल्ड विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग वीजा फ्री एक्सेस टू द इंडियन सिटीजन. एंड रिमेंबर, आउट ऑफ दीज 58, मोस्ट ऑफ द नेशंस आर फ्रॉम द एशिया, फ्रॉम द यूरोप. देर इज ओनली वन कंट्री विच इज प्रोवाइडिंग वीजा फ्री एक्सेस टू इंडियन सिटीजन, एंड दैट इज सर्बिया. ऑलराइट, देर इज ओनली वन यूरोपियन कंट्री विच इज डूइंग दिस. And talking about our close neighbors, so China is at the rank 70, and 75 nations are there which are providing visa-free access to the Chinese citizens. Pakistan, it is under the category of worst passports in our world, 107 ranking, and there are 32 countries. Nepal, 104 rank, with the number of countries providing visa-free access to the Nepali citizen is how much? 38. While the worst passport इन द वर्ल्ड इज ऑफ द अफगानिस्तान. अफगानिस्तान का जो पासपोर्ट है सबसे खराब है, बिकॉज ऑफ द ऑब्वियस रीजन, बिकॉज ऑफ द लॉट ऑफ टेररिज्म देयर. इट्स रैंक इज 110, इट इज एट द बॉटम. एंड देर आर 26 कंट्रीज इन द वर्ल्ड विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग वीजा फ्री एक्सेस टू द अफगानिस्तान सिटीजन. ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज अबाउट द हेनलेस पासपोर्ट इंडेक्स, एंड दीज आर सम की पॉइंट गाइज विच यू शुड रिमेंबर. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एज आई टोल्ड यू, इट वॉज द फर्स्ट एडिशन वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2006 एज हेनले एंड पार्टनर्स visa restriction index, and it was modified and renamed in year 2018. Since 2018, Japan has the most powerful passport in the world, as I told you. Last year India's rank was 84, lekin jo India ki best rank thi wo thi in the year 2006, that was 71st. In 2006, when the first edition was launched, India's rank was 71st, lekin uske baad India ki jo rank thi wo niche aati gayi, and it is currently at 85 this year, but the last year it was 84. All right. So now let's come back to the question. I hope you can easily answer this question now. So you have to identify the correct statement. In 2021 index, India is ranked at 85th position. Yes, this is absolutely correct. With 58 countries providing visa-free access to the Indian citizens, Afghanistan has the worst passport in the world. Yes, absolutely correct. 110, it is at the bottom. And there are 191 countries in the world which provide visa-free access to the Japanese citizens. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And that is why Japan is at the number one. So which means option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer here. And now let's move on to question number two. This is also a very important question, guys. Which of the following services can be availed through the newly launched e-portal that was launched by CBDT for filing complaints? And talking about CBDT, so current chairperson of CBDT is who? Mr. PC Modi. So, and CBDT looks after the collection and levy of the direct taxes. And for the indirect taxes, we have a separate body which is known as Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs. And this body is currently headed by Mr. M. Ajit Kumar. Alright, it's M. Ajit Kumar who is the current chairperson of CBIC, which deals with the matters related to indirect taxes and customs, while CBDT deals with the matters which are related to the direct taxes. Alright, and CBDT has launched this e-portal for filing complaints. Let's talk about this portal. So what is the portal? www.incometaxindiaefiling.gov.in. Alright. And what is the purpose? A person can find complaint against tax evasion, against Benami properties and foreign undisclosed asset. In teen cheezo ke against complaint ki ja sakti hai on this portal under Income Tax Act of 1961 under 3 acts. And number one act is Income Tax Act of 1961, Black Money, Undisclosed Foreign Assets and Income Imposition of Tax Act 1961, and also Prevention of Benami Properties Act. Okay. Now guys, what is this Benami transaction? Benami transaction kya hota? So let us take an example. So let us say there is a person A and there is a person B. So let us name this person A as Guddu Bhaiya, while this person B is Kalin Bhaiya. Alright. And there is a property. This property is C. So this property is purchased in the name of Guddu Bhaiya. Okay, this property is purchased in the name of Guddu Bhaiya while the payment has been done by Kalin Bhaiya. So this type of transaction is known as what? Benami transaction. But remember here, there are various exceptions to, in this Benami transaction also. Like for example, a person can buy a property in the name of his or her spouse or her child. Okay, so वहाँ पे Benami transaction act नहीं लगता है. There are various other exceptions also, but this is the basic, you know, thing about the Benami transaction. Benami transaction basically क्या होता है कि एक person के नाम पे कोई property खरीदी गई जिसकी payment किसी और ने करी थी. And there are various exceptions. Remember this thing. All right. So now let's come back to the question. So we have to identify which of the following services can be availed through this portal. Grievance redressal, no. Complaints against Benami properties, yes, this is absolutely correct. Complaints against foreign undisclosed assets, this is correct. Complaints against corruption in income tax department, no, this is incorrect. While statement number 5 is complaint against tax evasion, yes, this is absolutely correct, which means 2, 3 and 5 should be the correct answer. Option C, only 2, 3 and 5 will be the correct answer, guys. And now moving ahead to the question number 3. With which telecom company, National Small Industries Corporation, NSIC, has signed an MOU for digital transformation of MSMEs? इसमें आपको ज्यादा डिटेल में नहीं पढ़ना है. Just remember, NSIC has signed an MOU with a telecom company and the name of that telecom company is what? Airtel. Okay, the answer is what? Airtel here. So you should remember कि किसके बीच में MOU हुआ है, between whom the MOU has been signed and what is the purpose? Digitization, digital transformation of the MSMEs. MSMEs को digitalize करने के लिए this MOU has been signed between NSIC and Airtel. So therefore guys, the correct answer here is what? Option B, Airtel. And Airtel chairperson is Sunil Bharti Mittal. Alright, Sunil Bharti Mittal is the current chairperson of Airtel. And moving ahead to question number 4. This question, the previous question, question number 3 guys, can be asked in the one marker. So it is also very important because these days government is talking about digitalization and government is also talking about the MSMEs a lot. So this question is very important. Alright. And question number 5. With which e-commerce platform Niti Aayog has launched revamped women entrepreneurship platform? So this platform guys was launched in the year 2018 by Niti Aayog. Basically, this is a platform for women where they can enhance their entrepreneurship skills. Okay, जो महिलाओं की entrepreneurial skills हैं, उसको enhance करने के लिए this women entrepreneurship platform was launched by Niti Aayog in 2018 and now it has been revamped. And for that, Niti Aayog has partnered with one of the e-commerce platforms. So we have to tell the name of that platform. Okay. So guys, the name of the platform is what? Flipkart. Flipkart is that e-commerce platform with which Niti Aayog has partnered to launch this revamped women entrepreneurship platform. So first of all, let's talk about this platform. So the idea of setting up of this women entrepreneurship platform was in the Global Entrepreneurship Summit that was held in Hyderabad in 2017. And this was organized by Niti Aayog. And after that, it was launched in the year 2018. Okay, and what is this? This platform is basically a unified access portal which brings together women from across the country टू रियलाइज देयर एंटरप्रेन्योर स्किल्स. ओके, तो महिलाओं के एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप स्किल्स को एनहांस करने के लिए दिस प्लेटफॉर्म वॉज लॉन्च बाय नीति आयोग एंड नाउ द रिवैम्प्ड वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप प्लेटफॉर्म हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ नीति आयोग विद द इन पार्टनरशिप विद फ्लिपकार्ट. ओके, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द न्यू वर्जन, अगर जो न्यू वर्जन की बात करें, सो द न्यू वर्जन विल हैव द मल्टीपल रीजनल लैंग्वेज सपोर्ट एंड इट विल ऑल्सो हैव एन एडिशनल फीचर टू ऑफर मेंटोरशिप टू द वुमेन मेंटी and this will be provided through an online dedicated mechanism of FICCI ladies organization which is known as empowering the greater 50% mission. Empowering the greater 50% campaign guys was launched this year by the union minister of women and child development. It is being implemented by FLO. okay, so iska jo online dedicated platform hai uske through mentorship will be provided in the revamped women entrepreneurship platform. All right, and talking about this campaign, so it was launched this year as I told you by Union Minister of Women and Child Development, not this year, last year. Now it has 2021 that has come. So 2020 mein isko launch kiya gaya tha. Its objective is to enhance entrepreneurial and decision making skills of the women. Okay, iska bhi wahi basic objective hai jo entrepreneurship skills hai mahilaon ke unko enhance karna. The implementing organization is FICCI Ladies Organization and it has a target to enhance the entrepreneur skill of 1 lakh women. Okay, how many? 1 lakh women over the next 3 years. All right, so this was the question. I hope all the news are clear and now let's come back to the question with which e-commerce platform Niti Aayog has launched this platform. So this platform guys is Flipkart and you have to tell me the name of CEO of Flipkart. Isse pehle maine aapko kai baar bataya, so write down in the comments the name of CEO of Flipkart. Okay, and that's it for the session guys. These are the 4 questions for today and I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.